Alderaan certainly is the prettiest world on our itinerary. Don't let all that breathtaking scenery fool you, though. This is the most dangerous planet of the core worlds. The nobles here could teach the Sith a few things about backstabbing and assassination.
You should hide in my bunk, where it's safe.
Tempting, but I'll take my chances with the nobles. I'm reckless that way. Every so often, the noble families spill their bloodlines fighting for the throne. The current succession war is the bloodiest on record. Since the Empire arrived to put its own puppet in charge, there's no telling who will come out on top.
Who's the big shot around here?
House Ulgo seized the throne, but maybe not for long. The whole planet's a war zone. The first time I visited, I thought all the nobles were so glamorous. Then I saw the truth. These people don't know how lucky they are, or what they should do with their fortunes. They don't deserve to rule.
I don't have much use for aristocrats.
You just haven't met a good one. Maybe I'll introduce you to one, someday. Your first delivery is a piece of glaze cake. All you have to do is escort that antique power droid to House Organa's castle. Since House Organa runs this spaceport and their castle is right around the corner, dropping off the droid should be a quick run.
The droid's my first delivery. What's the second?
One deal at a time, Captain. Let's focus on dumping that bucket of bolts. The droid belongs to a couple of young nobles, Len Taran and his sister Sidonia. Decent people, all things considered.
Got it. I'd better get moving. You made a deal with a woman named Risha for this droid. I'm here to collect.
Welcome home, you ugly little thing. I mean the droid, of course.
This is no time for your juvenile jokes. We should properly introduce ourselves. I am Lady Sidonia Taran, Herald of the Gold Aurora.
And I'm her brother, Lord Len Taran, Warden of the Eternal Flame. Please call me Len.
What should I call your beautiful sister?
Seti. She loves that.
Please don't listen to my brother. He has the unfortunate quality of being an idiot. My brother and I are all that remains of House Taran's noble bloodline.
One of Alderaan's more reprehensible pedigrees, House Baelis, slaughtered our family and seized all our holdings.
If that happened to me, I'd be raising an army.
Hard to raise much of anything when you haven't two credits to rub together.
This droid holds new hope for us, literally. Centuries ago, our ancestors hid something inside it for safekeeping.
Pirates absconded with the unfashionable machine generations ago. Tracking it down has consumed our family since before we were born.
What that droid contains will rebuild House Taran. But we need instructions to safely open the hidden compartment. It's rigged to explode, you see.
The instructions are at our family's estate, now occupied by House Baelis's forces. Without those instructions, we can't pay you.
Clean up this mess yourself. I'm done.
Unless we recover what's inside the droid, it's of no use to us.
The instructions we need are in a data pad of Taran family history at our estate's library. If you retrieve that data pad, we'll add a substantial bonus to your payment.
And there are some additional family heirlooms we'll pay you handsomely to recover while you're there.
What kind of security does your estate have?
Hard to say. I'm sure Baelis installed new systems after we fled.
Len, it's time for your meeting with House Organa. Don't keep their counselors waiting this time.
You just want this handsome stranger to yourself. Next time, dear sister, you get to beg our hosts for their table scraps.
What are you waiting for? An invitation?
I'll try not to come back too soon, dear sister.
Take your time here, Captain. I'll go stretch my legs.
I couldn't face another dreary meeting with House Organa's counselors. Thank you for sparing me.
I've been looking forward to a private chat since I got here.
I'll try not to disappoint you. When I was a girl, I dreamed of adventuring among the stars. What's it like, living that life?
Come to my ship and see.
That would generate no end of gossip. This is already quite a breach of etiquette, you know. An off-world man calling on a lady in private. People will talk.
Face it, you can't resist me.
I'm often drawn to things I'm not supposed to have. Regardless, I've kept you from your business long enough. Please, take care of yourself out there.
Rumors are filling the hollow frequencies of a daring robbery at our old estate. You've set a lot of tongues wagging.
House Baelis is missing a data pad from their new library.
I'll let my dear sister have the honors. Never could decipher that blasted thing.
It's a simple code, woven through the genealogical entries. You just have to assemble the letters correctly, Len.
You're obviously the brains of this family, Sidonia.
She's also very talented on the vioflute. Oh, and a gardener, and a poet, and...
Len, do shut up. According to this, we must pry open the droid's ventral servomotor housing and disable its lateral conduits. The holo chip is hidden within a false power storage unit, behind a detonite charge, entering the disarm code.
You sure we ought to be standing this close, Captain?
I've got it! After all these centuries, we finally have our proof. The information on this holochip proves House Turan is owed a considerable number of credits. When the other families hear of this, we will reclaim our status among the nobility.
I guess congratulations are in order.
Please, there's no need. We're just happy to be rich.
Then take this data and have it authenticated by the Royal Council. I'll see to our benefactor's payment.
I'm sure you will, dear sister.
I'll leave you two alone to negotiate. Call me when you need me, Captain.
I suppose you'll be leaving soon. You don't seem like a man who stays in one place for long.
I always have time for a gorgeous lady.
There's a charming crudeness to your romantic gestures I can't help admiring. One advantage to being an honored guest at House Organa is access to their finest food and drink. I can arrange a special meal for the two of us. We'll eat and talk about your adventures.
What happens when I run out of stories?
Why don't we start a conversation and see where things lead? Follow me to the parlor. We'll pour ourselves a drink while we wait for the food. Aren't you glad you decided to stay?
This is great, but it's time for me to go.
Already have one foot back on your ship. I wonder what sort of woman it will take to settle you down. This datapad contains your payment for delivering the droid. It's the schematic for a powerful anti-radiation shield invented by House Turan. The shield will protect your starship from lethal cosmic rays. You should give the datapad to your business partner, Risha.
What's she gonna do with it?
Build the shield, I believe. I assumed you knew all this. I also have your reward for recovering our family's heirlooms. I'm especially grateful for those. You risked your life for House Turan, and we'll never forget that. Farewell.
You got House Turan's schematic. Perfect. That wasn't too bad, was it?
That Sidonia was really something.
Is she your type, Captain? Interesting. She always seemed a little cold-hearted to me. Your next delivery is to take that head in the jar to a sniveling little stuffed shirt named Pima Ahuf. Pima is at House Alda's estate. You'll have to sneak through some tough battle zones to get there.
Why does some noble need a head in a jar?
It's a history thing. If you're that interested, ask Pima. His lectures are thrilling.
Can't wait to ditch that creepy head. I swear its eyes follow me around the cargo hold.
This is one delivery I recommend keeping covered. Let's not upset the locals any more than we need to. Good luck, Captain.
Guided tours of House Alda's Royal Museum are closed until further notice. I have nothing against off-world visitors, but please leave, or I'll be forced to call security.
Do you want this head in a jar or not?
I most certainly do not. Get that disgusting thing out of my sight. I mean, really, what sort of buffoon brings a counterfeit head and expects payment? House Alda has already obtained the head of Darth Bandon, thank you very much. It was genetically authenticated by one of my conservators yesterday.
Maybe this Darth Bandon had two heads.
Don't be ridiculous. Yours is obviously a forgery. Cadreth? Cadreth, come here!
Yes, noble curator. How may I serve your impeccable rectitude?
Where is Nava? I want her to run the genetic authenticator on this head and prove it's a fake!
I haven't seen Nava since she authenticated the other head yesterday, noble curator. I sent a message to her holo, but she never replied.
I smell a womp rat.
This estate is vermin-free, I assure you.
Cadreth, perform a genetic authentication on this head at once. Compare the results to the head we received yesterday.
I beg your patience, noble curator. This process will take some time. I'm afraid we have a slight problem. This head is a 100% genetic match for the Sith Lord Darth Bandon. I retested the head Neva verified yesterday, and it does not appear anywhere in the genetic authenticator's database.
Somebody owes me an apology.
And someone owes me an explanation. Captain Skavik, this is Noble Curator Pima Ahoff speaking. I demand that you return the Arcanian hyperdrive at once. The head you bought it with is a counterfeit.
Sorry, Pimi. I have a strict no-refunds policy. Hey, Captain. You're a little late to the party.
I should have known you were behind this, Skavik.
I promised you'd regret crossing me. Hope you don't mind, Pimi, but Neva's taking an early retirement. She's too gorgeous for life in a museum.
What? You menace! You corrupted that girl!
Wasn't that hard, trust me.
You won't have much use for women once me and Huey get done with you, Skavik.
You still got that giant vibra sword? What are you trying to compensate for, kid?
He just wants his torchy back.
Sorry, Corso, but that's a grown-up weapon. You just put out your eye. I wish I had a hollow of your face right now, Captain. That expression is just priceless. Have fun eating my vapor trails.
This is unthinkable. Skavik has committed a grievous affront to House Alder.
I was promised payment for this head, Your Worship.
The hyperdrive was to be your payment. It's an extraordinary apparatus, custom built by one of Arcania's most brilliant engineers. Skavik received the Arcanian hyperdrive at the spaceport yesterday. If he's still there, he must not have finished installing it. Skavik cannot leave Alderaan without a functioning hyperdrive. Hurry! Catch him before he escapes!
Waste any time, did you, Captain? Bet you ran quicker than a Viracto on hot sand. Not that it mattered.
How does he always manage to get away?
Yeah, sorry I can't be there in person, but my sweet little Neva is very sensitive to violence. Don't worry, though. My friends here will show you a good time.
This is a preview of what I'm gonna do to you, Skavik.
Hit it, men!
You're either the luckiest shot in the galaxy, or those were some seriously unlucky mercenaries. I guess I'll erase this holo recording.
Luck had nothing to do with it.
Right. I'm supposed to believe it was your amazing reflexes? Look, I hate to cut things short, but I got a swanky new hyperdrive to install. Love that Arcanian tech. Take good care of the rest of my stuff, Captain. I'll be coming for it soon.
Just found out what's happening. Sorry I'm late. The good news is, I tracked Skavik's ship to House Thule's spaceport. He must have gone there to finish installing that hyperdrive. There's still time to get him.
I'll fly us to that other spaceport in no time.
Throttle down, Captain. It's not that simple. The Empire controls House Thule. Skavik has landing clearance from the Imperials, but you'll have to sneak in on foot. Luckily, someone here owes me a big favor. I've arranged a meeting to sneak you inside that spaceport and get the hyperdrive.
What if I don't make it back, Gorgeous? Will you miss me?
Don't be ridiculous. You always survive. My contact is at these coordinates. Oh, and there may be a way we can profit from this whole debacle. House Alda still wants the head. That pompous gas bag Pima Ahoff will probably pay anything to get it.
He'll pay me what I want, or I'll fry him.
Pima? I think all you'll have to do is threaten to muss his hair. Good luck, Captain. I'll be waiting.
Hello again, Captain. I understand Skavik has escaped. I was, truly sorry to hear that.
I still have your head. Got anything useful to trade for it?
We got off on the wrong foot, didn't we? I apologize if I was rude before. You must understand, the head of Darth Bandon is a priceless artifact. He was the Sith Lord who murdered one of Alderaan's noblest sons. Centuries ago, Trask Ulgo bravely sacrificed himself in combat with Darth Bandon. Trask's martyrdom saved the Galactic Republic.
I don't care about your history.
No, of course you don't. You're an off-worlder. Let me put this in simpler terms. Alderaan's current king is of the Ulgo family bloodline, and he reveres his ancestor Trask. The remains of Trask's murderer will be the perfect peace offering to our king. House Alder must have your head, so to speak.
This is a pretty weird peace offering.
Had you been raised on Alderaan, you would understand. Any payment in credits I give you for the head now will have to come from my own funds. I'm not a wealthy man. Please, I beg you, for the love of peace and posterity, please accept my offer of what little I possess.
As long as I get a Hall Jets out of here, fine.
You are very gracious indeed, and a credit to your profession. I must deliver this head to Baron Alder at once. Thank you for your understanding. Farewell.
Chonki faguta, chiho poda jioto vokise.
What's wrong? You're too good to speak basic?
Patoga wata kiko uba kiri wata buki donko. Se gota do muti kihasa da punyo, liz di woto. Kupa tonti toki maki chisa chubolo wawuni.
If I needed luck, I'd already be dead.
Kabano tase makipuna, mali tuta udmishka. Kichawa joto du debita tuta ulia, nuja.
Where's Skavik? I'd like to chat.
Nakag agib, kik minabab. Nea agam berakaki. Bomo gala apayang. Nilama imi amka amgap? Nayana ramkam. Kala ama mani mami. Libik bak.
You got suckered by one of the galaxy's great con artists.
Manub meraka naja. Kinamabam. Yak manala. Bragam nimya, inu buyin. Kamamka amka nanya. Beraka karam kara. Ninyamok oramag yang nigig.
You're not going anywhere until you junk Skavik starship for me.
Nibaka klamka. Gakyam. Glaknimu amya galak.
There's another shuttle soon.
Ibikari empam pulun heknar. Nulilak apa jam kamgram. Amka nem nang nemua inuk. Gala jiwa nimok. Ebemgam nyama naya aigam.
Thanks for the help. You can go.
Nani kara mirik agam. Ja uklibik. Yamemgi, benak akalak.
Thank the stars. We're in desperate need, and you're the only one we can turn to.
Everything was fine when I left.
I'm afraid events have quickly turned against us in your absence.
Duke Bayless was offended by your visit to our former home. He's demanding satisfaction. The Duke is sending his son, Zin Bayless, Alderaan's finest marksman, to challenge me to a pistol duel to the death.
Is there a reason you're whining to me about it?
Because you're someone accustomed to danger, and... I'm not.
My brother never mastered the art of the blaster. He can't possibly face Zin. Unless we find a champion to take Lin's place, he's as good as dead. Please, will you be our champion?
What's the upside for me?
We'll reward you well to fight on my brother's behalf. Please, come to House Organa at once. Zin will arrive any moment, and you must be here to meet him.
Just in time. We were, about to start without you.
Pathetic. This vile-looking off-worlder was the best champion you could find.
Nice robes, pal. Sew them yourself.
Inform your simple-minded servant he should not speak. I have no compunction about killing your second first.
Draw.
Ah! You filthy mongrel! How dare you violate the rules of noble combat? The duel hadn't even started!
What about now?
Stop! Stop, blast you! The duel is ended! You win!
Leave House Tyrann alone. Understand?
They're not worth another moment of my time. I can't believe you shot me without waiting for the duel to start. Twice!
You saved my brother's life.
Not only that, you did it with style. Where did you learn to fight like that?
Little here, little there. Mostly I make things up as I go.
Ah, so you're classically trained?
There are no words to express our gratitude. This reward will have to suffice.
You could kiss my wounds and make them better.
I would happily oblige if our circumstances permitted. My brother and I must flee House Organa. It's only a matter of time before House Baelis makes another move against us.
Nobody will mess with you as long as I'm around.
You've faced enough danger already. We can afford to hide someplace very safe, thanks to you. Captain, we will always remember you as our champion. Farewell.
I've never been so happy to see a starship part in all my life, but I'm even happier to see you in one piece.
How about a kiss for coming back alive?
I'm excited to see you, but not that excited. I have to hand it to you, Captain. You not only took care of business, but you made Skavik look like a fool.
I worked his ship over pretty good.
He'll probably just steal a new one, but at least he's a few steps behind us. I'm glad we're done here. It's funny, I can't help thinking Nokdrayan would have hated this world as much as I do. Legend is, Nok was descended from royal blood. They say that's how he got to be king of the galactic underworld before he died.
Someday I'll be king too.
Well, you're off to a good start. Attitude is everything. It won't take long to wire the Arcanian hyperdrive to the ship's engines, and the anti-radiation shield will be a snap to build.
What's so special about this Arcanian hyperdrive tech?
It's 100% accurate for 30 parsecs. Trust me, you need this. I'll have those upgrades online and... wait. Hang on. Oh, this ought to be good. Hello, Skavik. How's Trix?
Just fantasizing about killing you and your friends, sweetheart. Want to hear the details?
Did you like those special modifications I made to your ship?
You mean Senator Taltow from Alzok 3 Starship? I'll make sure your name comes up when he files his insurance claim.
Haven't you learned yet, Skavik? Cheaters never win. We're leaving Alderaan with all the prizes, and you're, well, stuck being you.
Have fun while it lasts, kids. The end of the ride is coming soon.
You know that old saying, it never rains but it pours? Today it's pouring holocalls. I'm getting one from Tatooine of all places. Jiren, I haven't seen you in forever. I'd love to catch up, but this isn't the best time.
Someone took Aldila. Said I'll get her back in pieces if you don't come. Pieces! You have to help me.
We don't have time for this. Cut the transmission.
Jiren, I won't let anything happen to you or Aldila. Calm down and start over.
When I came home from work, Aldila was gone. There was a man waiting for me. He said unless you want to be responsible for Aldila's death, you'll meet him at an old Zerka mining complex in the Chini Rift. I don't understand, Risha. Why is this happening?
It's a trap, obviously. But my odds of surviving and getting Aldila back alive are a lot better if you help me spring it.
I like your sentimental side.
Enjoy it while it lasts. I only show it once a year. Jiren, stay on this holo frequency. Let me get in touch with some contacts. We have to play this smart. Alright, I dug up everything I could about the Chini Rift and that Zerka mining complex. I'd say we've got a 50-50 shot at coming back alive.
You know what always improves the odds? Cheating.
I already factored in cheating. You should have seen the original odds. Chini Rift has more holes in it than a chunk of Bis cheese. The Zerka mining complex sits over a network of caverns. Zerka sealed the complex's mine shaft when they left, but didn't bother with the ore processing chute. You can use that to get inside.
And then what? That man will kill Aldila if we try anything.
I'll keep this mysterious kidnapper distracted by surrendering to him, while my friend sneaks up behind.
I don't like this. Using women for bait? What kind of man allows that?
Are you getting sweet on her? Is that your problem?
I don't even like her. Doesn't mean I want to see her hurt.
If you care that much, Corso, feel free to jump in front of any blaster bolts coming my way.
What can I do to help?
Nothing. I'm not explaining to Adila how I got you killed. Just wait outside and be ready to give her a kiss. I marked a route through the caverns to the ore chute, Captain. I'll give you a head start to get in position.